Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, the leader in e-commerce accounting. And today I'm going to walk you through how to do bank reconciliations using Xero bank feeds. And watch until the end so that you can get a free copy of our ebook, e-commerce security best practices for security in a virtual world. Now, let's get started with step one. Okay, so step number one is to set up your bank feeds. Okay, so we're going to start from here. We're going to click on Get Bank Feeds. When we do that, it's going to ask for our username and password. We will fill those in and click Next. Then it's going to take a couple of minutes to connect. And when it's ready, it'll take us to a new screen. All right, so here we are. We're going to pick the matching bank feed. And if we check this box, it allows other people to refresh the feed on a daily basis if they'd like to. I'm going to leave it unchecked. And then you have to decide whether you want all the available transactions, usually that for banks that only goes back 60 to 90 days, or you can pick from a specific date. So let's say I've done the accounting through November and I just want it to start December 1st. I'm going to do it like that and click OK. And then it will pull in all the transactions from December 1st on. All right, so it's going to take me back to the dashboard where it shows that I have some items to be reconciled. And that's going to take us to step number two. Step number two, reconcile your transactions. What you do is you just click on the blue button. This is going to show you everything that came over from your bank. This is from your bank. And it wants to know how it needs to go into Xero. At this point, you really have two options. You can either create the transaction here, or if the transaction already exists, you can match it against it. So let me show you an example of each. So in the first case, the transaction already exists. If you were to click over to account transactions, this is everything that's already recorded in Xero. So in this case, this one exists. It was recorded on December 2nd. You'll see it's unreconciled. So it exists, but it hasn't been matched against anything that came from the bank. That's what we're doing here when we reconcile. So what you can do is just click OK to match the bank transaction against the Xero transaction. Okay, you click OK and it's done. And if you go over to the account transactions, you'll see that it now says that it's reconciled. So not only was it entered, but it also got matched against the bank transaction. Now in this case, no other transaction exists for this. Because we'd already coded something to Costco in the past, Xero will suggest how it should be coded, but you can overwrite this and code it however you want to. Enter description, enter division, whatever, tracking categories or whatever you want to do. But in this case, I'm just going to say, yep, that's an office supply. And I'm going to say OK. And then when I look at account transactions, now I see both transactions in there. Okay, so you can either match it against a transaction that already exists, or you can create it from scratch. Okay, now here's a bonus tip for you. Dun, da, da. You can set up bank rules to make things go faster. So let me show you how that works. I'm going to actually undo what we did, remove and redo. When I do that, it's going to get rid of these transactions in Xero, but look, it's already over here under reconcile. Okay, so we're back to where we started. I'm going to create a spend money rule. So anytime we spend money with Costco, what's going to happen is the system's going to see that, and it's going to suggest, actually more than suggest, it's going to strongly suggest that a transaction be created with all of this information that I'm typing in, okay? And I'm gonna put a note down here that tips me off to where I'm gonna code this, okay? So this is the rule. So what the rule does is it says, okay, Xero, anytime a transaction that comes in from the bank that goes to Costco, we want to automatically create a transaction set up so that it's coded to Costco and that it's coded to the payee Costco and also has the account office supplies. So if I go okay, if you look over in account transactions, you'll see both of those transactions exist. And it even has a memo in it that says office supplies because I told the system to do that. You can split transactions and do all kinds of funky stuff that I'll show you in other videos at another time. But suffice it to say that you can automate things and make things go really quickly and cleanly by using that feature. So we've reconciled our transactions. Great. Now let's go on to step 3 for a monthly double check. Okay, so let me just take a second and explain what's happening right now. When the transactions come down from the bank and you're creating the transactions and you're matching them together, you are reconciling the transactions on a daily basis. This is different than how it used to be before cloud accounting, before bank feeds. The way it used to be is you would just record transactions on your own, doing your own thing. And at the end of the month, usually like 10 days after the end of the month, in the mail, you would get a paper statement that told you what the balance was. And you would do a manual monthly reconciliation and make sure that you got everything. Xero has changed that completely and has turned it on its head so that you're reconciling every single day. So now there's no need for the end of the month bank reconciliation that a lot of accountants have come to know and love, okay? However, that doesn't mean that you shouldn't double check your work at the end of the month. So the next step, step number 3, is your monthly double check. And honestly, I do this more often than monthly. Usually our team does it weekly, but we're just trying to make sure that we're on track. So what we do is we go up to the top where it says reconciliation report, and we're gonna pick the date that we're comparing against the bank. Usually that's at the end of the month. For credit cards, that might be at the cutoff date, which could be in the middle of the month. In this case, we're gonna go take a look at the end of December. And we're going to see what the balance is according to Xero at the end of December. Xero seems to think that we've imported this amount and there are no reconciling items, okay? So this makes us all happy. But the way that you know that this number is right is by comparing it to the bank. So let's look at the bank statement. Okay, here's our bank statement from the big fancy bank. It has an ending balance of $1,996.38, which is exactly what we have in Xero, so we know that it matches. Some reasons why it might not match, one could be you've recorded transactions in Xero that haven't yet cleared the bank. Another reason it might not match is because there was an error in the bank feed. Maybe you started the bank feed on the 5th of December, but you missed all the transactions the 1st through the 5th or something like that. You know, maybe there was just some kind of technical glitch. So the vast majority of the time when we check it, it's spot on, but you should always do a monthly check just to make sure. And that brings us to step number 4, which is protect your work. After you've gone through, you've reconciled all your bank accounts and everything, go up to settings and change your financial settings. You can go to settings. If you don't see financial settings under it, go to general settings, and that'll take you to the screen that shows you where the financial settings are. Once you get to financial settings, you lock the ending date so that there can't be any more changes made to your file. If I've reconciled everything and I know that my books are good through the end of December, lock that so that it won't change it. And I would argue to do both dates, even this bottom one, because this is stop all users making changes. This one is only for, it's for everybody but advisors, but if you close it, you know, advisors make mistakes too. So protect yourself by putting a date in both of those. So now you know how to reconcile your accounts in Xero. And a lot of people who are just starting out with Xero, sometimes they have questions about security. If that's you, I invite you to download a free copy of our ebook, Ecommerce Security, Best Practices for Security in a Virtual World. The link is below. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends, and be sure to subscribe. Catch you next time.